King Drunk, back again with something completely different. And it is completely different. It's one of those sort of video chain things, which I was tagged in by Northern Southerer Beer Reviews, John. And it's a set of 9 questions, and you basically just basically say what you say. So the first one is, how did I get into beer? Well, to be honest with you, getting into beer is like my home city of Glasgow. It was like when you turn your terrible teens, 16, 17, everyone just did it at the end of the week. A Friday and a Saturday night was always beer, and it was, back in those days for me, it was Tennent's Lager. Everyone used to drink the Tennent's Lager, Tennent's Super Lagers and stuff like that. Just terrible teen stuff. That's basically my first introduction to beer. Question 2, what is your favourite beer? Favourite beer, if I had to be pushed, I would probably say Guinness, if I had to go anywhere with it. Although, I drank Guinness for years and years and years, and suddenly I discovered it wasn't the best stout in the world. There was better ones out there, with the craft beer explosion and obviously real ales and stuff like that as well. But I would probably say Guinness, to be honest. It's still a bit of a go-to pint. If I'm in a bar and it's not got any real ales or craft beer, it's the first beer I'll have. It still is a cracking pint, to be honest with you. Question 3. One beer forever, what would it be? Well, probably years ago I would have said Guinness, but I know now there is a lot of good beers out there, but I probably would say it would have to be a stout anyway. If they were to abolish all types of lagers, IPAs, pale ales, rye beers, whatever, all sorts of beers, and it was up to me to say what beer gets brewed, I would probably say stouts and porters, to be honest with you. It is, to me, is fantastic. I love that style of beer. Question 4 is, how can you drink so much? I don't know. Is it in my genes to drink so much? Well, obviously, it hangs over my genes now, to be honest with you. How do I drink so much? It's not really. I think a lot of people got a lot of misconceptions about people that do beer reviews, to be honest with you. You think that this is a full-time job. We just sit behind a camera and get drunk every day of the week. We don't. We hold down relationships and jobs, and we just do it. I do it. I am guilty of binging, I've got to admit that. I am guilty of binging, but I'm no way an alcoholic. I can go off beer for weeks at a time. Although you might see videos up there all the time, I've done these videos ages ago, and they're just sitting on my computer waiting to get uploaded. I'm not an alcoholic, to be honest with you, but everyone's a wee bit guilty of binging. Suppose if you listen to the doctor and you overdrink your units and you binge drink, you've got a drink problem, but I'm not an alcoholic. I don't see myself that way anyway. So anyway, moving on. There's another part to that question is, how do I stay so healthy? Healthy, well, up to a few years ago, I wasn't that healthy, to be honest with you. I was carrying a lot of weight, and even that, having said that, when I carried a lot of weight, I'm still pretty active. I do a lot of walking, and then up to a few years ago, I joined a gym, and I lost a lot of weight, and done a lot of running, but unfortunately, my knee and my hip are playing me up, so I've had to stop running. But I do a lot of walking. I'm one of those kind of people that if it's 2 flights up and there's a lift and there's stairs, I'll always, always take the stairs. I'm one of those kind of people. I like to stay fit, stay active, to be honest. Right, moving on. What's your question six is, what's your most favourite ingredient in beer? Oh, my favourite ingredient in beer has got to be vanilla. Touching back on my favourite styles of beer, which is stout. I love the taste of vanilla. I love the smell of it. I love the calming, soothing taste it gives. It's one of those great ingredients in beers. A lot of people slag them off, but Innocent Gun, I love Innocent Gun beers. It's basically vanilla. I love it. A bit of a vanilla junkie. Long live Innocent Gun. Right, question seven. Do you brew? No, I don't. But that's not entirely true. I did do a batch about 30 years ago. I'd done a batch of homebrew lager, and it was the house we stayed in the first time we got married. It was damp, it was cold, it was on the ground floor, and it was a horrible wee house, to be honest with you. And I also remember I followed the recipe to the book, and I always remember about 30 days afterwards, I took two bottles around to my dad, and we were going to drink it. So he got the glasses out the cupboard, and he poured the glass, and he was going, "My God, that looks nice and clear." It was nice, and then suddenly all this gunk from the bottom of the bottle went into it. And he was like, I don't think I'll be drinking that. And my dad was the sort of person that he would drink anything, to be honest with you. But he went, "No, I'm not drinking that, full stop." So I got my bottle and I opened it and I poured it into the glass until it was crystal clear, and then I stopped. And then we tasted it, and we go, that does actually taste like lager, and that's actually not that bad. But poured it down, we poured it down the sink, but now knowing that if I'd have left it maybe another month, or maybe another couple of months, the beer would have ended up clearing out, and it probably would have been okay. So I threw out about 8 gallons of beer. I remember going home and I just threw it out. I just poured it down the sink. What a waste. So anyway, last question. Question nine. What is it? Who in the beer world do I look up to? I wouldn't say look up to. It's I admire. I've watched their beer reviews from probably day one. I may not comment in every one of their beer reviews, but I still watch them. Would be Simon Martin, Real Ale Craft Beer, as he's now called, but I remember him back in the day when he was just Real Ale Guide. Simon Martin caught me on right away for his enthusiasm for beer, which way back I never had that enthusiasm, enthusiastic looking beer, to be honest with you. But it's grew on me. People like Simon, it's sort of like, it's a bit catchy in a way. Like, he would review a beer. He's reviewing all sorts of fantastic and wonderful beers now. But way back in the day, he'd be reviewing something like London Pride or whatever. No, like your bog standard beers you can get in the supermarket. And it would make you just want to go to your Tesco or your Asda and buy that beer the next day after watching the review. Him. And Beer Goggles reviews, Terry Kay. Terry Kay is a bit of a character. I like his swagger, his whole demeanour. He's a nice guy. I've met him as well. I met him at the Great British Beer Festival, Terry. He's just total character. He's just beer oozing out of him, if you know what I mean. He just loves beer. He's got great enthusiasm for any beer to speak at all, and a great guy as well. Who else? I used to watch those two guys, and then obviously you broaden, you sort of look at the, you go through the internet and you look at other people as well. One of the American beer reviewers, I'm not big on American beer reviewers, but there's a couple I quite like. The first one I started watching was Jay Theroux, Louisiana Beer Reviews. I just like him. I just like the way he presents his beer reviews. And he does breakfast beer reviews, which, hey, Jay, I love that. Breakfast beer, I do breakfast beer as well. Not done it for a while, but I do like it. Jay does breakfast beer reviews. I like in his beer review, he seems to get sidetracked and he goes on to something else, and he maybe show you an interesting book, or he'll start talking about something else, and then he suddenly realizes what he's doing and then he goes back to the beer. But Jay, and I also like Tom the Beer Whisperer. I like Tom as well. I like his. Tom is not a beer reviewer, to be honest. Tom just sits and he basically, it's like being in a bar and he's just sitting. He's just chewing the fat with you. I like that style of beer reviewing as well. There's another American guy as well, Paul. Paul from PA Brew News. I like Paul's style as well. Paul's a bit like myself, but he's a dark one, right enough. I always refer to Paul as the dark one. Paul likes his dark metal and stuff like that. And I like him when he used to sit in his wee dungeon. And I always had visions behind the camera. He'd probably have somebody tied up and he was beating the shit out of them in between beer reviews. He's got that lovely darkness about his beer reviews, and I quite like that as well. I would say those guys as well. There's a few new ones as well that I quite like as well. Like, obviously, John from... what is it? Northern Southerner. Northern Southerner Beer Reviews. I like the guy nominated for this. I like John's stance on it as well. He's just like myself. He just likes a beer and he likes to chat about it. These guys are all... There's hundreds of probably I've not had a chance to see, or I haven't discovered yet. But beer reviewing is just... It's out there. We all have it, and it's like part of your... It's my hobby, to be honest with you. I like doing this, to be honest with you. So anyway, you have to tag people to do this video. So if you stayed along to the end of the video, Sofa King Drunk tips his glass to you. So anyway, whom I got to tag to do a video response to this? I'm going to tag, firstly, I'm trying to think about, there's going to be lots of people who are going to say, your usual guys, and I don't want to go the usual guys. I want to go my sort of cult, as I would class them, the cult beer reviewers out there. I'm going to go with Jay from Louisiana Beer Reviews right away. I think Jay would be brilliant at this, to be honest with you. I'm going to go for Tom. Another USA guy, Tom the Beer Whisperer. I think Tom would be good at this as well. Hopefully Tom will do it in a bar. He does location videos. I hope Tom does this in a bar. And I'm also, the third one I'm going to go for is another American. It's Paul from PA Beer Reviews, the dark one himself. And I'm going to throw out another couple, another one as well. Another American. I just realised I've written it on my page here. Another American is Kevin Clements from the Clements Home Brew. Him and Christian. I think him and Christian, the two of them, if you know who I'm talking about, you know exactly what I'm saying. These guys are just... Kevin always comes across as a lover of life, and he likes to share everything with everybody. He a cracking guy, to be honest with you. Him and Christian, like, as his son, they sort of bounce off each other, and stuff like that. I think that Kevin and Christian, the Clemens Homebrew, coming at you, I think those guys would be good doing this together. Kevin, if you watch this video, I want you to, I want you and Christian to do this video review together. Don't do it yourself, do it together, because that'll be good viewing. A couple of new guys that have started, one was Stravail, which he was beer reviewing a few years back and then he went off the scene. Now he's back on the scene, Stravail, and an American lass that I've been watching, Tonya, what is it, Tonya Markowski. I hope I've got your name correct there, Tonya. That's another girl, maybe likes a have a go at this. You may, if it's for you, if it's not, fair enough. I like, personally, I like watching beer reviewers. I like watching the high-enders, the ones that get all the views. But I also like watching guys out there, the cult, as I call them, the cult beer reviewers. The ones that get the low subs, that just churn out the beer reviews all the time. There's some crackers out there, like Dean's Beer Reviews, The Clueless Drinker, there's names escape me just now, but these guys are well worth a watch and well worth a mention, to be honest with you. But anyway, the ones that I've tagged, hopefully you watch this video and hopefully you will do a video response to this. So this is SofaKingDrunk and a video response to Northern Southerner Beer Reviews. Cheers, John. Slangy Va. Keep reviewing the good beer. Ciao for now.